Now here the question is, if the maximum distance of any point on ellipse x square plus 2y square plus 2xy equals to 1 from its center be r, then r is equal to. So what we'll do is, first we'll find center of this conic or center of this ellipse. So we'll differentiate this equation partially with respect to x and we'll put it equals to 0. So we'll get 2x plus 2y equals to 0. So we'll get x plus y equals to 0. And then we'll also partially differentiate it with respect to y. Then we can write this equation as 4y plus 2x equals to 0. We'll get 2x plus 5 equals to 0. Now solving both of them, we'll get x and y as 0 and 0. So center of this conic is at 0, 0. And we haven't studied it as yet. This equation represents a central conic whose center is at 0, 0. So we need not do all that. Now we need to find maximum distance of any point on this ellipse from its center. So what we'll do is we'll use polar equation. Say this distance is r and its angle is theta. So we can write x as r cos theta and y as r sine theta. So we'll use polar coordinates to find this maximum distance. Now we'll put x as r cos theta and y as r sine theta. We can write this as r square cos square theta plus 2r square sine square theta and then plus 2 r square sine theta cos theta and it is equal to 1. So from here we can write r square is equal to 1 upon, now it is cos square theta plus 2 sine square theta plus 2 sine theta into cos theta. Now cos square theta plus sine square theta is 1. So we can also write this as r square is 1 upon sine square theta plus 2 sine theta cos theta and then plus 1. Now this distance r, it is a function of theta. Now we need to maximize this distance. So either we can use trigonometry or we can use calculus to find maximum value of r. So you can solve it by taking derivatives. So differentiate this r with respect to theta and then put it equals to 0, you'll get the value of theta for which this r is maximum. So what I'll do is, I'll write this equation as r square and this is 1. Now sine square theta, I can write sine square theta as 1 minus cos 2 theta upon 2 and this 2 sine theta cos theta is simply sine 2 theta and then plus 1. So we'll write r square as 2 upon, so this is 2 plus 1, 3 plus 2 sine 2 theta and minus cos 2 theta. Now if we look at this expression, which is 2 sine 2 theta minus cos 2 theta, it is of the form a cos theta plus b sine theta. And we know that a cos theta plus b sine theta is always greater than or equal to minus a square plus b square. And it is always less than or equal to under root of a square plus b square. So for this expression, which is 2 sine 2 theta minus cos 2 theta, we know that a square plus b square is simply 5. So this value is always greater than or equal to minus root 5 and less than or equal to simply root 5. Now this r, and which in this case is r square, it will be maximum when this denominator is minimum. And the minimum value of 2 sine 2 theta minus cos 2 theta is simply minus root 5. So r maximum square will be 2 upon 3 minus under root 5. So we'll rationalize it. We'll write 2 and it'll be 3 plus under root 5 and it'll be 9 minus 5. So it should be 4. So we'll get r maximum as under root of 3 plus under root 5 by 2. Option number C.